Every single day, you're getting older and one step closer to your grave.
But you're not alone, because so am I. But why? Are we programmed to age? Because you see, nothing in nature says that we must. Some turtles, rats, lobsters get better with time, which makes sense if you think about it. As you level up, you're supposed to get stronger and better, not weaker and worse and dead. When it comes to humans, there are multiple what's. What is making us old? They are known as hallmarks of aging. As of this year, we have identified 14 such processes which have causal relationship with aging. Among them are genomic instability, telomere attrition, mechanical issues like glycation leading to stiffening, mitochondrial dysfunction, microbiome disturbance, compromised autophagy, inflammation, and a few more. All of them answer the questions of what and how, but not why. If you step into the Hall of Science in the University of Notre Dame, you'll see this medallion which says, "Nothing in biology makes sense except in the light of evolution," which is the title of a very important essay by Theodosia Dobryzhansky and one of the fundamentals of modern biology. So let's shine some light onto the question, why are we getting old? Evolution cares about one and only one thing: procreation. It doesn't care how long you live or how happy you are. Whatever configuration of external and internal factors produces more babies, that's what it cares about, that's what gets the green light. Whatever makes less babies goes to the junkyard of evolution. And if you look at humans, through 99.9% of our history, the expected lifespan was 40 years or less. Not because of internal factors like aging, but because of external factors like disease, war, hunger. So evolution never had enough material to work with to optimize for long life in the first place, because there was never enough old people. Instead, it chose a much easier road: make humans be able to procreate all the time and be horny all the time. And getting old in this game is not a natural design or a program, it's just a combination of bad luck and evolutionary negligence. But good news is, the field of aging biology, which started in the mid-70s, is growing. It really took off in 1993, when lifespan of C. elegans worm was doubled by trivial, by nowadays standards, mutation, and later on increased 10 times. Next year, fingers crossed, the study on humans called TAME should start, which is short for Targeting Aging with Metformin. It's absolutely crucial for the field because it doesn't target side effects like cancer or heart disease. It targets the root cause, the aging itself. So it's no longer a question of if, but when aging is going to be solved. If not this century, then the next one. But it's really up to us to speed it up and not to miss the train. Some people don't care, but I do. What about you? And if you want to live long enough to see what future brings us, live to be 100 years or more, not by luck but by design, you must be aware of all 11 things which drain your life out if you don't pay them attention. I've listed them all in this video, so make sure to watch it next. The law of minimum is brutal. If you ignore it, it will not excuse you. So be smart and stay in the know. See you there.